The improvement was majorly aided by a robust foreign exchange market and market transparency.
When you look at the five now East African countries, I think Uganda has the highest FX liquidity. And I'd like to thank Bank of Uganda for that, maintaining open market. They have bolstered that. And transparency. I think when you look at the East African countries, we are the one that has the most transparency when it comes to FX dealing. If you just went to the Bank of Uganda website, you can get to see all kinds of information about what's happening on a daily basis. And that data goes all the way back to, I think, before 1997.
So just how important is it for a country to have a robust financial market? Patrick Ayota, the NSSF Acting Managing Director, answers this question, drawing examples from the Asian tigers.
In fact, when you map it out, you find that most of them began to take off when their domestic long-term savings hit 30%. Because that means they could self-finance their own development as we are. NSF is the largest domestic long-term saving in the country. Right now, we're only 12% of GDP. So however much we try, unless we depend on donors, we'll not get anywhere. So we're very deliberate on the role NSF can play in this country.
It was the pillars in which Uganda performed poorly, like market depth and capacity of local investors, that provided basis for discussion as policymakers and key stakeholders deliberated on what can be done about it.
Government, through our National Business Development Services, we recently launched a framework for BDS, which is being coordinated by Enterprise Uganda under my ministry, aims at strengthening management capacities of our local businesses so as to boost their competitiveness at national, regional, and international markets.
Solutions were also provided. Story by Benan Ojambo for the news.